Psst, hey, kid, you want some numbers? Parsing in Final Fantasy XIV is a controversial subject. I, an upstanding citizen of the law, speak today as a diplomat and mostly in hypotheticals. Please don't ban me. Starting from the top, parsing, in the nerdiest definition possible, refers to the tabulation of your party's outgoing damage with a third-party tool. Universally, that's the Advanced Combat Tracker, or ACT. Basically, rather than digging through your in-game combat logs with a calculator in hand, ACT automatically puts all of it into a neat table and records everyone's DPS. That's it. That's parsing in its simplest form. So what's the controversy? Well, for one, ACT is not at all Square endorsed and is a completely third-party plugin, a big no-no. In theory, you could get in trouble for this, but Final Fantasy XIV doesn't install Riot Vanguard, so it's all an honor system anyway. The only time you can really get in trouble for ACT is if you draw a big target on your back by flaming someone with numbers from the parser. And honestly, if you're chewing out some Sprout and Sawmall because they're not optimizing their level 50 rotation, you're kind of a demon. Even in the raid scene, that sort of over-optimized parse culture is why Square doesn't want any official damage trackers in their game about catgirls. We've already seen semi-arbitrary third-party tools poison the well in World of Warcraft, where things like Raider IO scores made it a real uphill battle for new players to pug content. So I don't mind Square's third-party software policy, because it casts a kind of threatening shadow across overtly toxic behavior, and exclusion is not the main use of this tool. Let's just move on to what ACT is actually good for your average player. Personal improvement. While this game is, in broad strokes, easy, it is a fun endgame raid scene. The small 8-man raid size means there's a decent workload on everyone's shoulders when it comes to clearing DPS checks, including healers and tanks. There is one in-game tool, Stone Sky C, that lets you hit a special target dummy to see if you're dealing enough damage to clear particular bosses in rage, but that's like being told to play chess against 10 variously ranked bots to figure out your elo. It's not a realistic measure of your ability to actually play the game, and it really doesn't offer any great detail about your performance either. Enter ACT. Well, first, a parse on its own is pretty much just dough. It's a raw ingredient stuck on your computer. If you want to actually look at your parses in depth, you'll need another tool, FFLogs. This is the oven to your dough. When you upload a parse to this site, it formats all that raw data into a proper log that is way more readable and shareable. It also leaves a permanent record on your profile, showing your best scores for any set of fights. It should be noted that even if you've never touched ACT or FF logs before, you might have parses on here that other players have uploaded. You can, however, opt out of this and keep your privacy by going to the lodestone and adding FF logs hidden to your profile. Likewise, you can make individual logs private or unlisted. But if you want to do any raiding at all, I recommend leaving your profile and logs public. Upwards of 85% of raiders use ACT, even in mid-core and casual groups. Okay, I made that statistic up like any good rhetorician, but excluding console players who can't download ACT, most people who are even semi-serious about improving at this game parse, and statics do look at them when recruiting. Logs are a great, if totally imperfect, way of tracking your progress as a player and figuring out ways to improve. Now, I'm not going to completely dissect FF logs or its many tools here, but I will cover the core concepts. Probably the most important thing to figure out is how to actually read an FF log. Every upload is ranked on a 0 to 100 percentile scale. To read these percentiles easily, they're color-coded. For your average player, shooting for green to blue is a decent sign you're on the right path. But a clear is a clear. Even a zero gray is better than nothing at all. As you get more comfortable with a fight and your job and you start to optimize, you can shoot for purples and oranges if you want to push yourself. A 100 parse is incredibly rare and usually reserved for top players and parse-focused statics using parse-focused strategies. Next, there's how that DPS gets tracked. And this is veering into the realm of math, but essentially, FF logs distinguishes between your personal damage coming directly from your spells and abilities versus the bonus damage from buffs like Dance Partner or Battle Litany. Here is the official FF logs write-up on these different metrics. RDPS, or Raid Contributing DPS, is the default. It factors in theoretically everything by taking your actual damage, subtracting the damage you gained from others' buffs, then adding back the damage others gained from your buffs. It is by no means perfect, but it is what's used. If you want to get into nerdy math debates about these metrics in the comments, knock yourselves out. But I was a history kid. Like I said, we could go in together for 45 minutes just picking through FF logs and all its nooks and crannies, including fight replays and job comparisons. But instead, I'm going to put this very useful How to Navigate Through Logs article in the description down below. But before you go off to do all that, let's cover one other tool that really helped me get a little better at this game, XIV Analysis. After you've uploaded to FFLogs, you can copy and paste the URL into XIV Analysis, another site, which then lets you, well, analyze every player's performance in the fight at an admittedly kind of superficial level. Like the site itself says, it aims for the low-hanging fruit. But this is great if you're a beginner. The site won't make you a world-first raider overnight, but if you're brand new to raiding or your job and you want to push in the right direction, I can't praise it enough. It covers all the big reasons why your parses aren't where you want them to be and lets you know what to work on. You can also go to the FFLogs leaderboards and pick a top parse with your job in it, then compare and contrast whatever you're doing differently from these veteran players. Sometimes, XIV Analysis will yell at you for things that aren't exactly worth adhering to, but that's the nature of having a robot for a teacher. The biggest things to focus on are not dying, rolling your GCD, and keeping your DPS cooldowns aligned with your raid mates. If any of this helped you out, consider subscribing so I can gain micro-celebrity protection from the authorities' banhammer. Thank you, bye!